pretty much everything that you're seeing on the news up there back in Kentucky about down here is it's pretty true. I mean, Alex and I, my wife, Alexandra and I, we decided probably, I think it was about Wednesday of this week, to stay here. We started getting reports about I-75 northbound. It's pretty much a parking lot, so you're in stop-and-go traffic. So what normally would take you a five-hour trip to get to Atlanta probably would take you at least 10 to 12 hours, best you can do. You know, it's really crazy. Even as early as Tuesday morning, we started having water shortages for bottled water supplies and stuff like that, and then we started having propane shortages as well. So it's crazy. I mean, Harvey shook a lot of people up, and I think with Irma the size it is, it's got people scared. I would say unless you can afford to buy the very expensive Voss water, which is like $2 to $3 per bottle, and I think now most of that is gone, to be honest with you, and I think even things like Gatorade and Powerade is gone. Yeah, I would say, you know, the bare necessities, canned food. I went down the grocery aisle just a couple of days ago, and all that was left was a couple of cans of asparagus. Nobody wants that. But yeah, everything like beans and pork and beans and tuna and all your canned non-perishable good items are totally wiped out. It was really weird walking through a grocery store that is normally fully stocked and just seeing the shelves barely. There's nothing there, hardly. We're going to try to do our best. We've got all the supplies we need, all the water we need, all the food we need. And so we're ready to ride this thing out. And just main thing, I would say, is pray for us. That would be the main thing. If there's anything you want to do for us, just send us up a prayer that we can get through it and that everybody here will be safe.